We're at the Brooklyn Botanic Gardens today with Jenny Blackwell, manager of the New York City Compost Project in Brooklyn. Jenny and I are going to look at a few different styles of compost bins that you can consider to get started with turning your kitchen trash into black gold, stuff that your garden will love, and material that will definitely make your plants smile. Can you tell us a little bit about what this area is?
Yeah, we're at the compost demonstration area, and this is where visitors can learn a little bit about what kind of composting systems you can use in your backyard.
So these are bins that you can buy or bins that you can make?
That's right.
Cool, let's take a look.
This is the Garden Gourmet, and this is an easy-to-assemble bin that comes together in snap-on pieces that you put together to form this box.
Starting with the top, we've got the lid that opens up. You put your kitchen scraps right in there, and you top it off with some leaves or shredded newspaper or wood chips. And going down below, it's got the air slats that lets the air in, which is really important to composting. And then it's got a sliding door on the bottom that you open, and that's a way that you can check to see how your compost is breaking down. What's nice about this bin over some of the others?
A great thing about this bin is that it's a smaller, more narrow size, so it fits easily into urban backyards. So this is the earth machine, which you can see has a lid that easily slides around to put your kitchen scraps and your leaves in there. Along the sides, it also has the air slats to let in the oxygen. And then in the bottom has an easy open door to harvest your compost when it's finished. So another nice thing about the earth machine is that it has pegs that anchor it firmly into the ground. And as you can see, like the Garden Gourmet, it is made of black recycled plastic, which draws the heat of the sun and insulates the compost even in winter months.
We're looking at the bio stack here. One thing that I noticed is that it doesn't have a door in the front.
That's true, it doesn't have a door. But a nice thing about this bin is that you can see that it's stackable. So you can add more layers to increase capacity. But even at this level, it's a great height for kids to come in, open the lid, and add their kitchen scraps and leaves.
Now we're going to take a look at some homemade bins that can be put together with some pretty simple materials, even materials that you can find on the street. Jenny, what have we got here?
So this is a two-bin system that's made out of 2x4s, and you can see you can lift this up and lift up the slats on the side to make it easier to turn the pile or add new materials. And the way that this bin works is that you start by adding all of the fresh materials into this side, and then when it's ready to be turned, you simply move it into this side of the pile, and then it starts curing in this bin.
So you've always got a space ready to accept your fresh greens, and then you've got cured humus that's almost ready to go in the garden.
That's right.
What about the snow there?
Another nice thing about this bin is that it doesn't have a top on it, so the snow and the rain can get in the bin and keep the materials moist.
And I've seen bins like this made from skids or pallets that were thrown away just sitting on a street corner. Ends up costing almost nothing to make a bin.
It's a good way to recycle materials.
I love that bin. This one inspired me to design a similar bin that we use today, works very effectively. Let's take a look at this one.
Right, so this is a homemade wire mesh bin, and you can see it's made of very simple materials. We've got hardware cloth on the outside, wooden stakes to go into the ground, and then PVC pipe to get oxygen into the middle of the bin.
I see it's also open to the elements, so it gets moisture from rainfall and snow. And I know from experience, this is super easy to make. This next bin we're looking at is one that reminds me of what used to be called an ash can. This bin's got a different use now. Let's take a look at it, Jenny.
This is the trash can composter, and you can see that it has holes drilled into the top and on the sides. And this is simply just used by lifting up the lid and adding your materials inside and closing up the lid tight.
So this kind of bin would be great for the city because it's absolutely rodent-proof once that lid is snapped on tight.
Right, that's the best thing about this bin.
Can we take a break?
Of course.
Let's sit down over here.
Nice bench.
You comfortable?
Yeah.
Stand up. It's also a compost bin. So this is another kind of homemade bin that you can make at home with untreated wood. And you make the bin, and inside is a place where you can add your kitchen scraps and your leaves.
And I see that it's got a hardware cloth lining, which also makes it rodent proof.
That's right.
So it just closes this way, and it's a nice resting area.
It's really nice for the garden.
Composting is certainly not a new process. It's been going on forever by farmers and gardeners in big piles on their lands.
Yes, but these are some of the ways that we've adapted composting for small spaces and urban living.
It's a great process no matter how you do it.
That's true.
I'd like to thank Jenny Blackwell, the manager of the New York City Compost Project in Brooklyn. I'm Annie Hauck-Lawson, Master Composter.